Hi, it's August 28th, and I'm back in Saddle Mountain in Ojai in the Barn Studio, and I'm working on a series of Thomas Fire-inspired vessels that have the charred Thomas Fire feeling with spring coming up on top with the luster. So I rolled out some slabs this morning, and these are just setting up, and then I'm going to put bottoms on them. This face was slumping a lot on the bottom, so I padded some plastic that will help me be able to get it out later. And I'm just going to let this set up, and the bowl on the bottom will keep it from bellying out and slumping. And I'm going to take this one out of the bowl. We'll see how the bottom is holding its shape. Take the plastic off. Doing pretty good. Top on this one, it's kind of funky, so I'm just using a pin tool, and I'm just going to carve a free form rim on here. This one is looking interesting. I curved in the lip a little bit, so it kind of has like a flowery petal type of feeling. And then I'm going to start applying molds. I made these plaster molds of Matilaha poppies. When working with the molds, I take a little sock with cornstarch in it, and then I just kind of dab where the impressions are, and then this keeps the clay from really sticking in there. And I'll just take it and press it into part of the mold. Because this mold has an undercut there, I can't pull it up from this edge, so I have to work it up from this side and then pull it out, and then I have my impression. I'm going to put this one on the back right there. It kind of feels like that's where it should go. So then I take a needle thing and very gently go around, make a circle where it's going to go. Because this is so thick, I'm going to carve out the back. I'm going to score, slip, and apply it on. And the slip is just crumbled clay, scrap clays of the same clay, this buff sculpture. I'm going to put some on here. Like that. And then I'm going to take this and apply it. And I'm not pushing the whole thing down flat. I want part of it to be raised so it has some interest to it. So more or less we'll go around the edges and really secure the edges down. Underneath, there's going to be air under it, but I'm going to put some holes through it so that it will breathe and won't blow off. But I like having the raised relief and playing with the puddles. And then what I like to do is I just kind of like to tack it down in a few spots. It doesn't have to be tacked down everywhere, but just a few spots so it's going to stick. Here's the one I'm going to apply to the other side, and you can see all this extra clay is what I'm going to blend in to the vessel so that these pop out.